cheesecake. We got to cast them a little bit yesterday. But Adrian's family on the other side, familiar names for sure. ALG, Leaf 6, I know Mega Beaver's over there somewhere. But, I mean, what else can you tell me about this squad?
Well, yeah, it's, I mean, they're probably the most known because of their great TMM sort of standard. I mean, they're great TMM players, quite familiar or quite infamous in terms of the pub scene. And they're great individually skilled players. I mean, I have seen them play a few games or a few sort of tournaments as a team, but I think the main sort of signature, you know, part of the team is definitely their individual skill and what they can bring to the competitive scene in itself. So you might even expect some new kind of different heroes we wouldn't expect in the competitive scene. Kind of similar to sort of the Rexars team. And so, yeah, I'm looking forward to these games, actually, because I think we're going to see something maybe even a bit new, a bit fresh.
New and fresh indeed, but right now we're going to be looking at some of those heroes that have been pretty dang dominant in the scene relatively recently. We saw some fantastic showings from a Parasite yesterday. We're going to see it one more time right here from Donkey Kong as they pick up Bubbles and Gauntlet as well. So they're definitely gearing themselves toward a little bit earlier game in terms of their team as of yet. This Gauntlet's going to give them some great initiation potential as well as the Bubbles with its initiation and counter initiation. And yesterday we saw Quincy stats about the Gauntlet. He was telling us they were going to lose 17.6% win rate throughout the recent competitive matches. And then he goes on to win yesterday. Saw fantastic play. I mean, how are you feeling about this Gauntlet pick?
Yeah, I mean, I honestly think the stats is what something that really threw me off, because I expected the Gauntlet to be, you know, have a lot higher win percentage, and to sort of see him only at 17.6%, I'm kind of surprised, because I think the hero is very, very good, but I definitely think the laning phase is where he excels at because of that grapple. Obviously, he's a good ganking hero in general because of his Gauntlet Blast goes through Shrunken Head, so it can stop any pesky Shrunken Heads and TPs out, but I think Gauntlet might have been having a hard time in terms of the Kindred Cadaver, but I think the hero is still good enough for a sort of first pick in the first picking stages. And I think he could work in this draft as well. They picked up the Parasite and the Bubbles, so this kind of ganking sort of oriented style of draft, I think it could definitely work. The only issue that might be is if they keep following this line that they kind of sort of pigeonhole into a certain style of draft or sort of style of play, and if it goes past that, then they might have issues winning the game past that kind of style of gameplay. So we'll have to see in the game how they decide to even round off the draft or how they decide to play in the actual game.
You're absolutely right. I'm loving the Wretched Hag Swiftblade, though. I mean, the amount of burst damage that's going to be able to come out of there. If Swiftblade, you know, gets off a good ultimate, Wretched Hag gets off the good ultimate, that's going to be very strong. But we'll have to see. Heroes that aren't going to be joining the fray. So far, we got Magmus and Kraken being banned out here by Slasked. And he's definitely trying to get rid of some of those heroes that do have the initiation potential. Maybe somebody that's going to be able to suicide or even end up in that middle role. And that's something that the Hellborn team is looking for right now. They don't have much in the way of the initiation. Somebody that's going to be able to get in there and force the engagements. While on the other side, they're going to be eliminating some of the stronger supports. Already Torturer being picked up by the Hellborn side. So your number one support gone right there. Rhapsody definitely still available right here. And then you've got some like Aluna that are still available. But Empath being banned out. And ALG also eliminates the Moon Queen. What's that all about?
I honestly have to disagree with that, because look at the style of heroes they've already picked up for Donkey Kong. There is no really way they can pick up a Moon Queen and get away with it safely, because there's no way they can really lane it safely. The only way you could maybe get away with it is if you run a tri-lane in terms of a Moon Queen, because otherwise the other team is going to tri-lane against it and shut it down. But as they've already picked up the Parasite, there's no way they can really lane Moon Queen in a, you know, a safe lane and give her a farm. And so I think the ban was really unnecessary. But going back to Donkey's draft, I really do like the Parasite into the Bubbles pickup, because the one issue when you pick up a jungler this early in the game is that the enemy team can quite easily counter it in terms of, like, you know, setting up a tri-lane and shutting down a hero. But if you pick up a Bubbles, you can just run the Bubbles in the short lane and just maybe rotate jungles with the Parasite and just let Bubbles go against the tri-lane. So you're really just kind of effectively winning the laning phase, because you're letting one hero go against three heroes while you're still farming a jungler and winning the other two lanes as well, most likely. And so it really does help in terms of gold XP. So I love the sort of the jungle pickup into a strong sort of suicide hero like a Bubble. So already liking the draft coming from Donkey Kong. I think the one thing they do lack is a little bit of late game potential. Maybe it's like a nice strong solo carry like player, like even Bushwhack. I mean, we haven't really seen too much of that kind of hero, even Corrupted. But there's the Glacier. So there's the Tri-Lane coming out. The
Sure.
one issue, I think, is that if they do decide to run Bumbles in the short lane, this Tri-Lane coming out from Hellborn is going to be a little bit ineffective unless they get a lot of kills onto the Bubbles, which is unlikely, but we'll have to see.
Yeah, I could tell that they were going to be setting up for this aggressive Tri-Lane. I mean, we saw yesterday via the stats that even through the play yesterday, that Empath is actually really, really good as a dual lane versus a Tri-Lane. And we saw yesterday that Empath with the aggressive walls worked out, we saw from the stats. And with the ban out from ALG onto the Empath, they look to run the aggressive Tri-Lane. It's going to be Swiftblade. It's going to be Ratchet Hag over there, probably in the middle lane. Bloodhunter maybe in the solo short. They can swap those two up. But Dark Lady being picked up now. And I feel like these lanes for the Legion team are pretty set. I mean, Bubbles in the short lane against aggro Tri, dual lane long for Dark Lady, Rhapsody, Parasite wherever he needs to be with Gauntlet mid. I feel like that's going to allow the Legion team to shut down the short lane farmer. It's going to be able to get some decent levels on the Bubbles, while the Hellborn are going to be forced to probably rotate around a little bit to meet those.
Beef, like, do you believe in love at first sight? Because I do, because this like Legion draft is absolutely perfect. I'm so in love with it, because even if they decide to run Dark Lady in the short lane, say if they run him as a solo, if Hellborn decide to like man up Tri-Lane, Dark Lady's still going to get enough farm because he's got a Taint Soul and Hatchet, and he can still get away with his Charging Strikes. At the same time, the Dark Lady offers quite enough sort of physical presence and carry potential, which this leading side was lacking. And at the same time, it allows Bubbles to go in the suicide lane and most likely win his matchup 1v1, and which is just perfect pickup, to put it simply. Like, this Dark Lady is just perfect. I'd really like to see this Dark Lady go bottom lane, but they might not decide to do that. He's looking like he's going to go top maybe and then send Bubbles bottom. Either way, it doesn't matter too much, because, I mean, if Bubbles was going to go top against, he was most likely going against a Bloodhunter, so he would have probably lost that lane, actually. So the lane isn't too bad. The only issue with this is that the supports coming out from Hellborn are most likely going to rotate instantly. Whereas if Dark Lady stayed bottom, I think their supports would have stayed there, and I think they could have, or Legion could have started winning on terms of golden XP because they've got the jungle factor in Parasite. But nonetheless, I think they just want to maybe focus a lot more farm on Dark Lady than just give her a little bit in terms of going against a Tri-Lane. So we'll have to see, though, because Hellborn have already set up their Tri-Lane with Swiftblade, Glacius, and Torturer. So.
And I got to say, this is actually really unfortunate for the guys in Donkey Kong right now. They are going to be looking to get wards, of course, here on the Rhapsody. But I'd love to have seen a ward maybe somewhere in their Legion jungle, protecting them from the possibility of the dual roam. And because this Rhapsody is not loading, she's not going to be able to get over there and actually drop this ward soon enough. Like, she's going to be put into a position where she would then be vulnerable to the Swiftblade, Glacius, and Torturer. So that's really unfortunate, because that is a very small timing window that they actually need to squeeze in there. So we'll see. I mean, this is the kind of thing that if I was the Legion team, I might even ask her a remake at that point. But
I agree with you, man. Definitely, because, like, it makes a big difference, because you can almost definitely expect there's going to be a aggressive trial. I mean, look at the draft coming from Hellborn. Swiftblade, Torture, Glacius. They can't really dual lane a Hag. They can't really dual lane a Bloodhunter. It's obviously going to be an aggressive trial with Swiftblade.
Wow.
And if you know that, you can put so the Bubbles bottom, but at the same time, the two supports aren't going to just sit bottom trying to kill Bubbles. They're going to rotate mid. So getting like a wall, like you said, in the Legion jungle is perfect. But yeah, this Rhapsody is AFK, so that's going to be a little bit frustrating. But in the meantime, they're most likely going to try and win top lane and sort of shut out Bloodhunter as much as possible, but expect the two supports roaming as soon as possible.
I'm looking at those stats from Quincy. He dropped the earlier stat about Swiftblade that he's running. I believe it was a 56% win rate. I think that's what we saw way up there. Yeah, 56% win rate just as a Swiftblade. Aggro Tri-Lane Swiftblade bumps up to 70% win rate. And this specific aggro Tri-Lane, 100% win rate for 4 games. So they're running Swiftblade with the heroes he works with.
I'd assume so, but at the same time, I think that's those kind of stats are most likely to wins coming from Tri-Lane versus Tri-Lane. I think it's gotten to the point where you can't almost, the enemy team knows that you can't really beat a Swiftblade Tri-Lane, so they're just going to most likely try and dodge it. And so that kind of stat is most likely distorted in that sense, because we're not actually going try versus try. But still, that 100% win rate is nothing to really brushed aside, of course, because it's definitely a big impact. And I think the biggest impact in terms of the early game is going to be these two supports here on the Hellborn side, because it's their job that really needs to make them, you know, try and make some ganks, because Parasite and Rhapsody are fine just to sit on lane and farm, obviously, Parasite in the jungle. When you're not running a jungler, you need to get those early kills if you want to stay ahead in terms of golden XP. So look out for the Torturer and Rinoa here on Glacius, because it's going to be their job to sort of make the early advantage in the first 10 minutes or so.
I think you might be right, and we are going to be getting into this one. Rhapsody still waiting to buy those wards. She's going to be able to get them now, but it's definitely one of those situations that, I mean, maybe you don't ask for a remake right here, but you are put at a little bit of a disadvantage just because you want to be able to get those wards out wherever you need them early. And now there's no possible way that she can actually make her way over there to ward up her own jungle, but she's heading up to the top lane anyway.
Oh, no. I really dislike this choice. Sorry to cut you off, but I really dislike this choice coming out from the Hellborn side or the Hellborn supports to block Parasite's jungle. I mean, like I said before in one of the other casts, if you're going against a tri-lane when you have a pseudo-defensive tri-lane, there's no point even going against it, because if the enemy team plays it right, there's no way you can really win when you're a defensive pseudo-tri-lane going against a real tri-lane. So blocking the enemy camps just forces Parasite to go in the enemy jungle anyway. So you're wasting these wards because, you know, the Parasite's not going to be in his own jungle anyway. So these wards coming out from Adrian's family, honestly, in my opinion, just completely useless.
Well, I mean, the one ward aside that they dropped is going to give them the rune vision. It's going to give them a rotation vision as well. And the other two that they're using, one's going to be blocking the pole camp. I don't agree with blocking the pole camp right there. When you're already an aggressive tri-lane, I don't think that you really need to do that. They're not going to be ever getting into a position where they can actively use that that pull, just because you'd go over there and force yourselves onto them. But yeah, in the end, they're going to make sure that this bubbles gets pretty much nothing. But number one thing they're going to have to do right now is get lane control. Swiftblade needs to be power denying, and they are going to finally start power denying, but they're giving Bubbles a little bit too much space as this Torture is starting to rotate back into the middle lane, and it looks like he'll probably go top and maybe even block a hard camp. But what do you think this Torture is doing?
I'm assuming he's going to be going top, but at the same time, I think this is another bad call, because I think Glacius will have to rotate over as well, because if you look in the top lane, there's three Legion heroes, and they're most likely going against two for the Hellborn, and just simple maths can I say that three is going to be better than two, obviously. And I think this Torture is just going to almost be feeding the Parasite and Rhapsody and Dark Lady. So I don't really like this rotation. They're about to spot it here right now, because Parasite's most likely going to spot Torture. Maybe not. Didn't get him in the end, but they're eventually going to know that Torture is here, and Parasite's going to be like really pesky to this dual lane up here in the top lane. So this Torture is going to have a little bit of trouble unless his position is perfect, although he's going in dark lane. I don't know if he can catch him. He can't. I mean, dual lane with a Blood Hunter isn't the strongest of situations on it, honestly, at the same time. So
yeah, it's one of these things that I'd almost like to see them rotate the Glacius up there, if that's something that they're going to be interested in doing. But I guess they're going to want to give Swiftblade a little bit more of a head start down here, make sure that he's able to finish up his Iron Shield, maybe get some boots, stack his regen a little bit more. But so far, they're not doing a very good job against Bubbles. I mean, Hardier is sitting at 6-2 against this dual lane, and they're losing this bottom lane pretty hard, in my opinion.
Wow. Yeah, I mean, he must be playing exceptionally well, though, because I mean, you don't really normally see this to be like doing, like you said. I mean, it's very, very rare for... He was going against a tri-lane as well for the first couple of minutes, so Hearty are playing very, very well on the Bubbles. One issue I'd like to point out as well, though, is I think Gauntlet is doing exceptionally well against a Hag. I mean, range versus melee, I think the range will most likely come out ahead like 80% of the time. But I mean, Gauntlet hasn't gone for the hatchet, so maybe like the extra bit of regen he's decided to go for is, you know, the reason why he's winning. Well, he's not really winning per se, but he should be losing. So in that sense, he is winning the middle lane. I think he's got his bottle coming out on the Curry as well. Yeah, he does. Yeah. So yeah, that's honestly really well played. To be fair, because going against a Wretched Hag, probably one of the strongest harassers for me against melee heroes. So he must be playing very well as well. Something I wouldn't really be expecting to come out from a Gauntlet versus a Hag. When he gets high level, though, I think that's where he can start winning the lane, because Hag can't really sort of stay in lane, because otherwise Gauntlet can just burst him down with his ultimate. And even from a Roam coming out from Parasite, seeing as he is in the enemy jungle. So be wary of that. But we are back into the game, so hooray, hooray.
And so we are. Hopefully not too many more pauses, but of course do need to allow the competitors to make sure to fix any of their technical issues that they might be having. And in the end, I mean, this is kind of the time to do it. The qualifier match is important, but you want to make sure that you're all kinds of fixed up before you do get into the official matches of the Golden or Diamond Cycle starting in about 2 weeks, which I'm excited for, man. I'm not going to actually be there being able to cast during that opening weekend.
Sad times,
but,
man.
I'll be doing my best to watch. Torture is in some trouble. Dark Lady going to be able to get off one more auto for the kill? Yes, she will. Bloodhunter might be able to get a counter kill here, but with no boots and only 1 point into the Blood Sense, not going to happen. Dark Lady would be easily able to run away there, and this is kind of what you're talking about. They didn't even need the Parasite, though.
That's true, and I mean, at the same time, dual laning with a Bloodhunter isn't really the strongest thing to do because he can't really offer that much, and so just bringing the Torture over here wasn't the strongest of decisions. And at the same time, he has to run all the way to the top lane, so he didn't get any XP. I think Rhapsody was already level 3 at that time, and so he just wasn't offering that much. But yeah, there's like a lot of disconnects. I think that's what you're gonna try and say. Oh wow, there's a lot of DCs.
Oh wow. Yep. That is from both sides. All the Danes going down.
Damn. Wow.
That is a little bit awkward.
Dane DDoS.
Oh, no kidding. It looks like
at least it was from both sides.
Teal's coming back in.
Sit.
Huh. There was a little bit of a misplay right there. The Parasite, I think the entire reason why he wasn't able to actually get that rune up top was because he was disconnected, as he kind of just walked right by the rune as Wretched Hag was going to pick it up. And I'm like, why aren't you picking that up? But I guess he was running back to base.
Yeah, he must have been DC'd. That's a little bit frustrating. Oh well, but at least, you know, somewhat even. I know there was more players in the Legion that were DC'd, but I mean, at least it was both teams for some reason. Oh well. What can you do? Online tournaments happen, I guess, like this. So. A little bit unfortunate.
There you go. Bad, because third world country. Please, no flame about North Germany.
North Germany.
Sorry, that's a troll directly to fantasy.
It's about damn time. But yeah, the game is back underway. But yeah, just going back to this Torture though, he just isn't offering a lot to this lane. I mean, he was only level 1 when he came up here. He is level 2 now, so at least he's got something. But dual lane with a Bloodhunter in any sense is a little bit of an awkward situation. And I think it just goes back to the draft, honestly. Hellborn just expected to be going against a tri lane, and Legion, done the right thing and just dodged it completely, put in the bubbles then. And Bubbles doing very, very well considering he was against the tri lane. Already picked up his boots as well, and it's giving Swiftblade a hard time as well. Swiftblade's only 270 GPM, and when he was babysat by two different supports, I would expect him to be doing a little bit better, but I guess it's just to the fault of Bulbasaur. So well played by him. He might be in trouble. The Glacier is coming around the side. If he can get a freeze off, Swift Slashes is available.
Yeah, he's going to want to wait until Bubbles actually uses that Shell Surf to farm, but Bubbles is not going to do that up top. Dark Lady in a little bit of trouble. Going to get stunned out by the Torture and take a lot of impalement damage, but Bloodhunter is one of these heroes that is just not capable of really getting involved in these team fights unless there's a lot of lockdown already, at least until he's able to hit level 6. But he is getting relatively close to that level 6 mark.
Yeah, when Bloodhunter gets level 6, I don't think Dark Lady and Rhapsody can even stay up here, to be honest. And at the same time, Parasite sort of left them, so they're kind of actually doing... they don't really have any place in this lane. I don't think they can do much. Dark Lady's going in on the Torture, but he might be in trouble actually himself.
Yeah, I think he is. The auto attacks are coming out. The impalement is there, and down goes the Dark Lady. ALG going to be able to put in a few right-clicks onto Rhapsody, but I doubt he's going to be able to get this kill, although he is flying around relatively fast because of the low HP Torturer standing behind him. Meanwhile, at the bottom lane, Bubbles is a little bit for a Shell Surf. They could dive him. They are going to dive the Rhapsody as he does hit level 6. Rhapsody goes down. Middle lane, Wretched Hag is having to run Ring Around the Rosie from the mid tower. And bottom lane, Bubbles is going to be dove here. Goes for the Shell Surf. And Swiftblade going to be coming in for the spin. Bubbles should go down right here. Hardier just... Heart Rior is just getting a little bit too aggro down there, as it looks like the guys from Adrian's family put themselves up 3-1 in hero kills.
Man, that was all those little events just happened so quickly, and you know, you see the golden XP swing lead or lead swing just completely, you know, go in favor of Hellboy. I mean, I think it was in favor of Legion for the most part, because they set up the lanes the right way. But I just think after the DC, Parasite went into his own jungle, which left Dark Lady and Rhapsody vulnerable. Bloodhunter did get level 6. He might be in trouble, though. Skeleton King is there, but a good ward placed here by the Torturer, spotting out any rotating ganks from Parasite.
Rhapsody might actually be baiting a little bit. No, she's going to go for a ward behind the tower, and now she's in a lot of trouble. 5 seconds left for the ultimate here from Bloodhunter. He might not even need it. Dark Lady's going to be coming in. Glacius going to be able to get a slow off, and Torture is going to survive. Parasite might not be so lucky. Heads into the Wolf Commander, and ALG does have the ultimate available if he swaps his boots and goes for the mana battery. And I think he's just going to be able to walk Parasite down. In fact, one more auto attack will be enough. And Gauntlet actually going to be coming in here. Bloodhunter's into trouble. The ultimate from Gauntlet, but Bloodhunter's able to get that mana battery off, finishes off Parasite, and here comes a hasted Wretched Hag. Gauntlet is in some trouble. Blink forward into the haunt, gonna be slowing down Gauntlet. Bloodhunter backing up, gonna go for some creeps, says Wretched Hag, this one's all yours. Next sonar screams up in 3 seconds. Gauntlet has a hook available, but it looks like he's just gonna try to live. This Bloodhunter's maybe a little bit too low. Gauntlet gonna go for a hook and will get it. The auto attacks from the tower might be enough. Gauntlet gonna turn that kill around. Wretched Hag gonna blink forward. Gauntlet going to fall. But it was a nice turn up top. Glacius gonna drop at the hands of Dark Lady. The boots and the Dark Blade's gonna be enough. 11 kills so far in this 8-minute game.
It's so much action, but yeah, going back to that Gauntlet, I think that was the right play to make. I think he was most likely going to be dying to Hag anyway, so to get the return kill onto ALG on the Bloodhunter was a great play to make. But yeah, I think this top lane, though, is just... They need to regain control of it, and I don't know if they can even regain control of it now. Parasite's only level 4, Rhapsody's level 4, I guess Dark Lady is level 6 now, but... I mean, whenever Bloodhunter does get his ultimate off, I think this is a free kill up top lane. Bubbles killed himself to Ancients, I guess that was... I didn't really get to catch it, I don't know if you saw that beef, but... I'm assuming that was the right play to make. Killed himself because he was low HP, or...?
He was definitely running away. I think he was maybe a little bit worried that Bloodhunter was going to TP down there and ult him or something. So he gets himself killed to the Ancients as Gauntlet's hook goes directly through Wretched Hag. I don't think that was going to be a kill one way or the other, but yeah, top lane. Dark Lady is in a lot of trouble. Glacius even dropping the ultimate. And that was kind of a crazy ultimate sound. Bubble's gonna go forward, gets the silence off, but there's no way he's gonna kill him solo here. Does have the backup coming in from Rhapsody, and they will be able to get this kill onto Glacius most likely, although Torture comes up, chain reaction onto two. Parasite gonna be the first one to fall right here. The impalement damage from the Torture is going to be ticking down the Bubbles, but Bubbles is gonna get the counter kill onto Glacius first. In the background, it looks like Wretched Hag is able to eliminate the Rhapsody. And the Hellborn team comes out on top, being able to take out 3-for-1. They might cap it off with a tower. Gauntlet's on the side over here. Might be able to go for a hook, but he's 1-on-4 plus illusions. This is really dangerous right now for the captain from the Legion team. He's going to be silenced out. TP's going to be coming in, and he is going to look for a hook. Got another couple seconds on the silence here. And we'll go for the hook. Not going to happen. Blocked out by creeps here. And might even get turned around on.
Blood 1 second.
Yeah, the ultimate is going to be popped off. And Gauntlet can do nothing but stand there. The auto is going to be plenty. Really questionable there from Sclassity Rhett. And now Rhapsody going to go down as well. No boots on her. The chain reaction into the autos. Finishes her off. ALG, the former Lions carry, going ham at 9-1-1 in this game. 479 gold per minute.
He has been absolutely dominating this game, and like, I mean, you could say it's like the bad play coming out from Donkey Kong, but at the same time, it's just great play coming out from Agents. At bottom lane, actually, Bubbles is going to be falling as well to Swiftblade. Man,
that was Dark Lady.
Agents family came to play. Oh, Dark Lady, sorry. Yeah, Agents family came here to play, man.
And they certainly did. I mean, Donkey Kong, one of the teams that was probably favored to take top 8 here, but as usual, Adrian's family, aka the Beaver family, aka I don't even know. I mean, they've been called so many different names over the years. What were they before? They were Pudge. What was
Jungle
the
Devo.
Jungle Devos?
Jungle Devos.
There you go.
Devos. Yeah, Dendy's Jungle Devos.
Dendy's Jungle Devos. That's what they were called like a year and a half ago. But they've been called so many different names over the years, and they're showing up.
Yeah, I mean, I think you could argue it's a little bit of a misplay coming out from Donkey Kong, though, because I did say once Bloodhunter gets level 6, there's no way they can really contest this top lane, because it's just a free kill for Bloodhunter every single time he wants it.
Oh, wow.
Unless there's a great... Oh.
And speaking of that Bloodhunter, he's trying to help get a kill. They do get a kill in the bottom lane, though, and that was kind of a really cool play, but now Hag's going to come in. Bubbles is going to get the Shell Surf off, trying to ward them back, but I think both teams are going to disengage. Anyway, they were baiting the courier, trying to get Bubbles to go on the courier, and that set up the ultimate from Bloodhunter. Fortunately, there was a gauntlet there that actually was able to assist.
That's cool to
but
see.
It was interesting the bait.
But yeah, I do like this rotation coming up. Actually, top lane Torture might be in trouble. Oh, good sidestep.
And the ultimate coming in from Gauntlet. They do finish him off. So Donkey Kong showing that they may be down, but they are certainly not out right now. Dark Lady is definitely one of those heroes that can help to turn games once she starts getting points. In the ultimate, team fights become exceedingly hard to take, especially when you've got people like the Bubbles. It's got another great team fight ultimate, and the Gauntlet. That's just going to have, you know, pretty dang incredible chaos and positioning inside of those team fights. And you can never count out a Rhapsody, man. Protective Melody, strong spell.
Yeah, man, that spell I've seen just almost win teamfight single-handedly sometimes, so you can definitely not, like, you know, like you said, write the game off before it's even started, because, I mean, we're only in the early game, and we've seen Dark Lady, actually middle lane, Hag might be in trouble, oh, Parasite could just, oh, the hook just missed as well, very, very close, unlucky there, coming out from Donkey Kong. I think they need to just maybe start looking for kills. I mean, Parasite is level 7 now, he's got the face hug, but an interesting build actually. He's maxed the infest, if you see that. I don't know if I completely agree with that, because I think, you know, the early gank potential that Parasite has is the main sort of reason you pick him up, and so maxing that leech is probably the best thing. It's bottom lane, there might be action
coming
in.
Yeah, they might be able to get the kills right here. Shell Surf going to be able to dodge the chain reaction, and it looks like our Bubbles is going to be in trouble. Gauntlet coming in, and Dark Lady going to be able to get the silences off right now, but Dark Lady's actually in a lot of trouble out of mana. Parasite going to be trying to help get the kill onto Swiftblade. The illusion's going to be coming in. Here's the leech, but the silence going to be going out. A huge Gauntlet ultimate, though. Swiftblade is going to be dropping right here. The illusion's helping to get those kills. Glacius maybe going to drop here as well. Catman Champion being taken over by Parasite, and he does get the stomp off, but then leaves the Catman Champion. I don't know about that one, man. And Chepe gonna try to TP on out, and I think not gonna happen. Ratchet Hag switches her boots, gets the mana, and gets the sonar scream, finishes them off, and now double the kills of their opponents. The guys from Adrian's family looking damn good.
Definitely, but it was only a 4-for-2, and Swiftblade did go down there, and that's probably the hardest carry that Adrian's family have, so at least they have some positives to take from this. Glacius was so close to dying there, I don't know if you saw, but he was nearly dying to the illusion, the illusion's just about faded. That was pretty, if he died to illusions, that would have been hilarious, but did not happen. Actually, Torture might be in trouble, there's more action, actually, Gauntlet, try and look for a kill, he might even be looking for Swiftblade up here. There is a lane ward, but I don't know if they've been spotted. I think, yeah, Swiftblade is playing back, so I think they do know Gauntlet is up here. I just think they need to stop maybe making use of this Parasite. I don't know if I really agree with the infest actually on Parasite, because I think you need to max that leech, because that way you're just, you know, really effective in terms of ganking, and only 140 damage because it's only level 2 leech. At least he can gank very, he can gank with the minions because he's maxed out the infest, but I don't know if I completely agree with that. What's your thoughts on that anyway?
I think that it's not necessarily bad if you're going to be doing a little bit more farming. And even as a ganker, I think that it can be effective if you're going to be able to get things like the Minotaurs, Catman Champions. It's going to give you a little bit more movement speed. It's going to give you a little bit more damage. It is more movement speed, right?
Yeah, 100.
Yes.
Max level, 100.
So, you know, I actually don't think it's that bad. They're going to try for a kill on a Swiftblade. That's never going to happen. He's just going to be able to spin too fast. They don't have a proper initiator up there without Gauntlet.
It's got quick fingers, that Swiftblade, though. I mean, if Darkly can get a Dark Blades and Charging Strikes, he maybe he can drop him down. We've got the Bubbles with him as well. Only level 2 of Song of the Caesar, so only 1 second silence. They probably have to time it perfectly. But something not out of the question there for Donkey Kong. Actually, bottom lane, Richard Tank might be in trouble. Parasite is in a Vulture Lord here. He's already going in.
And they got the silence off. Gauntlet with the ultimate is there. Hook. The big hit and the hook. Perfect lockdown. And top lane, they're able to get a kill on the Torture. So Donkey Kong showing that they have the ability to get these picks. They're going to go for a little bit of a counter ward right now as well. And if Dark Lady's able to get off the ground, she's going to do work. The biggest problem, still, the former Lion's carry, currently sitting in the middle lane, he's getting very close to a Sword of the High.
Okay, that is true, but at the same time, it is only a Blood Hunter. It's not really the scariest of carries. I mean, he can carry, don't get me wrong. Rather, obviously, see a Dark Lady with 470 GPM than a Blood Hunter with 470 GPM. So, yeah, it's definitely something to be worried about here for Donkey Kong, but at the same time, Blood Hunter doesn't offer all that too much in terms of the team fight. So he might be sort of snowballing now, but I think when he gets into the mid to late game, he might start falling off, we might see. But at the same time, they do have the Swift Blade as well for that even better sort of late game carry as well. It's just if Dark Lady can really get off the ground. He's 300 GPM right at the moment, and it looks like he's going for a Rune Cleaver. The Sword of the High just purchased from Blood Hunter, though. Got a DD at the moment. I don't know if he's looking for any kind of kill. Looks like he's just been farming at the moment. But at the same time, like, with Blood Hunter just sitting on a lane, particularly like middle lane, there's no way actually Hero of the Legion side is going to really farm middle lane because it's almost off cooldown. It's like an easy kill for Blood Hunter if he sees anyone in his own lane. So that's obviously kind of a thing that Legion need to work around. It looks like Bulbasaur is going to farm the jungle. Probably the only thing he can actually do at the moment, which is a little bit of a shame. But yeah, I think it's mostly just sort of farming at the moment. But I'd like to see Parasite and Gauntlet as well as Bulbasaur just try and work together, try and look for these kills from Hag, from the Torch, from the Glacius. These little easy pickoffs are going to boost their gold up for their own team and hopefully get them back into the game.
You know, I finally found out what that live wire noise that I thought was. Like, there's been this noise for like a few days now when I opened my Han, and I realize it's this radioactive Glacius skin. Like, he's got this little crackling around him, and then when he freezes things, it like makes the little Geiger counter sound.
Oh yeah,
I finally realized it, man. Blood Hunter in the middle lane, he's looking for an ultimate. He's really just looking for this tower, although Gauntlet is going to be hooking him in. I don't think that's something he really wanted. And Bubble's going to come in with the silence onto two. We'll get the ultimate from Gauntlet. Blood Hunter going to go down. Wretched Hag being hit by the staccato stuns. She's going to have to back on out of there. That was very well played by the Gauntlet and Bubbles. And a very necessary kill. Now, Parasite's going to be trying to get a kill onto Glacius. The puzzle box is there. The auto attack's going to be enough. Should be. And turning it around onto Wretched Hag now. Parasite's going to need to take cover in one of these creeps. Maybe in one of the ballistas here. And he's actually going to go forward. No! Getting into Wretched Hag, maybe. Or, excuse me. Getting into the cannon. Going on Wretched Hag. But no, he's going to be able to walk on out of there.
Donkey have brought it back from quite a big disadvantage. Yes, I know they are still 4,000 gold down, but I mean 1,600 gold or 1,600 experiences is nothing to, you know, be afraid of. And they're getting this bot tower as well, bottom lane most likely. Although Dark Lane might be in trouble. Invisible Hag coming up. They do take the tower down. He's got to get out if he can.
Oh, he's being greedy.
Very low HP.
Hag needs to wait for one more, otherwise this Dark Lane will turn and kill her.
Wow.
Very, very close right there to a death. Wretched Hag just a little bit too low. Needed one auto attack probably with that and would have gotten the kill onto Dark Lady. But instead, TDL going to fall back and it looks like she will be getting relatively close to the Rune Cleaver. At this point, do you still want to see that Rune Cleaver? Do you feel it's necessary?
All middle lane. Oh, you're just about. Yeah, I think. I don't know if I. It's hard to say. Actually, middle lane Gauntlet might be in trouble. Glacius, can he get the freeze off? He can. Bloodhunt is coming in as well.
And Gauntlet with that Helm of the Black Legion. Still not going to be enough. Bloodhunter should be able to get the Mach of Brilliance. There it is. Going to be delivered on the next courier. And it looks like Quincy's got another stat for us there.
Yeah, I mean, so 375 GPM or 450 minimum GPM, and that increased their win from 68 to 81%, but with 475 to 93, is that just on Bloodhunter? Is that right? Like, just on Bloodhunter? That's an insane amount of win percentage just for a Bloodhunter.
It looks like on all heroes.
Okay. Wow, okay. So he's getting very close to it, but I mean, at the same time, though, I did talk about how Bloodhunter is, you know, one of those heroes that, I mean, he does get a lot of farm, does sort of snowball quite well, but when he gets into the late game, it's kind of like a Dampier almost, because he can sort of snowball quite far. He doesn't farm as fast, but getting those kills is quite easy for him to do. But he does have the Mock of Brilliance now, so it's definitely something that Legion need to be aware of. But at the same time, Darkblade is closing in on the Rune Cleaver. Going back to the, sort of the question you asked me, I don't know if I completely agree with it, because at the same time, I mean, there's a lot of action going on at the same at sort of this time of the game, but at the same time, He's already started on the room cleaver. It's kind of hard to really back out. He could go for the null stone, which wouldn't be the baddest of choice. But at the same time, Legion need this kind of hard carry that's going to sort of carry him into the late game. And I think the room cleaver is the only sort of item that can boost Dark Lady's farm to, you know, credible lengths. And he looks like he's getting somewhat of a free farm now. So if you can finish off that room cleaver and then start sort of flash farming the jungle, I think actually it is the way to go. I just think it's going to be a tough road for Dark Lady ahead, especially his team as well.
It certainly is.
Blood Thunder going into the jungle now. Parasite's going to spot him out. That's a good placement there. The courier might be in trouble, actually, though. No, it should be fun.
Yeah, it should be fun.
Spotted the ward placement as well. They're looking for Dark Lady. Five heroes already engaging onto Dark Lady. Dark Lady just about getting away.
Yeah, she should know with plenty of advance, and I do not like them trying to defend this.
I agree.
I'm not sure about this at all. The Wild Hunter is going to be able to provide them some additional scouting information. Bubbles does just finish up a push stick, so they actually have the tools. Like, they have the tools to maybe be able to take this fight. Blood Hunter is not going to be eaten by the Wild Hunter.
The perfect initiation would be a gauntlet hook into tower, and then they'll burst him down before anything happens. It's all on him.
There it is. And Dark Lady going to be able to get the ultimate off. And Bloodhunter is going to fall. Swiftblade going to be able to get the ultimate off right here. Perhaps, but Rhapsody going to eat that ultimate, canceling hers. Looks like Dark Lady will survive. Torture going to fall to the Puzzle Box minions and the Leech. And the Legion team proves both of us wrong. Take a huge fight. And that's all the momentum that they needed right there. Dark Lady finishes the Rune Cleaver, and she's going to get to work getting that farm on. But here comes Hag finishing off the Parasite. And Dark Lady needs to charge forward and get out of there. Wretched Hag and Swiftblade on the hunt right now. Bubbles and Gauntlet still hiding behind the tower, and they're going to need to pull some fancy footwork. Bubbles with the take cover, the silence, and going to be trying to get out of there, but it's not going to happen. The radioactive freeze coming in from Glacius. They finish him off, and Gauntlet, it's probably time to sack this tower, but he says, screw that, man. I got 1,500 HP and a mana battery. I'm sticking here.
I mean, those hooks are honestly winning them in the team fight, but a great fake back, and they come out from the hell on side, getting those kills. They're going in for the hook. Hook hits on Hag, and he falls. But is it going to cost him his life? He's going to TP out, man. This Gauntlet,
he's playing phenomenally.
Is he Super KG in disguise? Can you please confirm?
Is this our Gauntlet that we actually saw yesterday?
Yeah, I think it was, wasn't it? And he was like landing all these crazy hooks.
I think it might have been.
This is Super KG in disguise. It's on a sub account, surely, right?
Sure. gotta address two things here in chat real quick. Earlier, I had said Parasite made a mistake by getting out of a Catman champion and then dying. That was not a mistake on his part. The creep was actually eaten by Bloodhunter. I forgot that he's got the new feast ability where he's able to eat a creep. So eats that one just like that. And then second, I've referred a couple times to the former Lions carry at being ALG. ALG was the carry player for Lions Esports before Flensmeister joined the squad in about November of 2012. Then played the sixth man for the team for a few months after that. But definitely some good experience right there before the Lions really hit the mainstream.
Yeah, now he's sort of captaining his team, and he's doing very, very well in this game. 420 GPM, it has sort of slowed down a tiny little bit, which I said would most likely happen because it doesn't have the sort of flash farming capabilities that of Dark Lady. But Dark Lady still doesn't have that strong an edge. She needs that strong an edge. The sort of tri-core items on Dark Lady is the Rune Cleaver and the Abyssal Skull and the strong an edge, and that's when she can start fighting. But she does finish up the Abyssal Skull now, but she needs the strong an edge before, you know, big team fights can happen. But they're still in a slight deficit, but there's something like they can definitely bring about. The kill on Hag, this would be perfect.
Up top, Dark Lady has no TP, and I'm surprised the Bloodhunter is actually not trying to go for the kill right there. I think that there was a very good chance that he would have at least forced a couple TPs in there, if not being able to get the hook
himself.
Rhapsody is going to have vision of this Bloodhunter, not giving it away, and she's just going to fall instead, not going to be able to get any stuns off.
And Rhapsody falls. Yeah, it's probably better that Rhapsody dies instead of the Dark Lady, of course. But sorry, what were you going to say?
I was going to say maybe trying to not give away the fact that they had wards right there, but the eye coming in right now from Ryanoa. Ryanoa? Yeah, Ryanoa. Is that like the Final Fantasy, what is that, 8 character? Ryanoa, right? Yeah, 8. Confirming, that is indeed Final Fantasy 8. Mini Maggot, he's either never played that game or he is disconnected. Confirming, Mini Maggot's internet is gone.
Hello, hello.
God
I'm
save
sorry,
the queen.
I'm back. God save the queen, man. Don't worry, the internet's still fine. God save the queen. We're still here, don't worry. Oh, I'm back. But yeah, going back. I think it's because it's my mute button, man. I keep touching, I keep fiddling with my mic, and it just mutes itself. I'm sorry. But yeah, it looks like Hellbound are taking Conga, and I think it's the right decision to make. Because, I mean, they've got map control, they've got the T1 down mid, they've got the T1 down bottom. They've got some good wars up as well as the Boundar, actually. And it looks like they're going to take this Conga without a hiccup. So really well played come out by Adrian's family here. And I think someone most likely going to be on the Bloodhunter. I think that's what the decision they're going to sort of put him on. Because I think it's probably he's going to sell his TP or the hatchet, so he's going to pick that up. And that's going to help them sort of siege any tower now, because he can just sort of stay in the front lines and start sieging towers. His TP in top actually, Gauntlet might be in trouble. He's got the ultimate ready. Or he's just going to farm up instead.
I think he's going to go for the hook right now. That was not even remotely right. Claim the lag. They're probably going to get this token, but it's time to get the hell on out of there. Dropping off the ultimate from Dark Lady. Will they be able to get out? Dark Lady has another charge. She might be able to TP on out of there. Gauntlet not going to be so lucky, most likely. Although he is very tanky. It's time to just TP, yeah. I think he's going to get out. Never mind. Radioactive Glacius is there.
TP! No!
He just didn't want to do it, man. They do get a counter kill onto the Torturer, though.
That's good. That's not so bad. And as long as Dark Lady doesn't fall. That was a really good trade, actually, for Nunkill. They killed Bloodhunter, so no longer took the token. They only lost Gauntlet. They got the Torturer, and Dark Lady survived. So he's closing on this Strong and Head. I mean, Donkey are playing this actually really, really well. Yeah, they are down a little bit in terms of golden XP. But, I mean, once this Dark Lady gets the Strong and Head, I honestly think that the team fight here for Donkey Kong is almost superior. And, I mean, this game is still anyone's game. Bubba's most likely going to be dropping here in the middle lane. He will. Not the biggest of deals. I mean, Dark Lady is the only one who can't die now. He needs a Strong and Head before they take the next team fight. And I think they can start winning these team fights. But yeah, like I said before, I mean, Beef, I don't know who's going to win this game.
I mean, you got the Tricore lineup over there on the Hellborn side. And they're all pretty farmed. I mean, minimum 370 gold per minute. All the way up to 430 for this Bloodhunter.
No, Dark Lady, no.
But Bloodhunter probably needs a little bit more.
He maybe
needs something like that Shrunken Head. And I didn't even bother commentating on that. I knew Dark Lady was getting out of there the entire time. Easy peasy. I gotta say, though, Rhinoa is playing fantastic in this game. 2-3-10. I don't like his avatar because it makes weird sounds. But he's been playing really well so far in this game, making sure to hold that bound eye, getting some counter wards down. He's doing a lot better than his other support here in Octo Jimenez-Dahl.
What does that even mean? I don't know Spanish, so or Swedish or whatever.
That's definitely not Spanish.
I don't know what it is, man.
Joaquin
Swiftblade might be in trouble here, actually. He's going in on the parasite's going on in him now, but he's just going to spin away. Hag is most likely going to get out as well. Yeah, there's no backup really for Parasite. He's most likely just scouting. But Dark Lady, he's closing on his Strong and Head. Do you know if he's got the Warhammer already? I don't know if you saw him in stash or anything like that. Do you know?
I am not 100% sure. We'll see in a second, since he is 30 gold off now, although one of his allies stole that last hit that he needed, which is really not good in my opinion. They know it's an illusion. The fact that she did not blink away or attack right there gives it away that she's an illusion.
That's true. But yeah, I mean, I think the main sort of game plan here for Donkey Kong, and I think Donkey Kong or File on the Dark Lady still needs the Warhammer as well, because she's got 1300 gold and hasn't purchased the Strongen Head yet. I think they're just sort of stalling here until Dark Lady gets the Strongen Head. I think that's the right call as well, because Dark Lady is too fragile now without a Strongen Head to really go in these team fights. It's just going to get bursted down completely. And as long as Dark Lady sort of survives in these team fights, I think they have the right initiation, the right lockdown actually. Because it's only the mid game, if you think about it. I mean, yeah, we talked about how the Tricore of Bloodhunter, Hag, and Bloodhunter, yeah, they're very, very scary, and yeah, they're going to have the superior late game, but at the moment, it's all about team
fight.
They're
going to catch the Parasite, though. Puzzle Box off, not looking to get the Puzzle Box off. He does have buyback. Gauntlet's there, probably going to throw out a hook. Not going to be the hook that he's looking for, though. And yeah, he's going to bait. Actually, Bubbles comes in, gets hit by the chain reaction.
Oh.
And Rhapsody a little bit too late. This is going to be the chain reaction of Feed. Rhapsody going to fall. And all of a sudden, Dark Lady, the only member of the Legion team left standing. And you're looking at a 17,000 experience lead. DDL does have the Shrunken Head coming in soon. But at this point, I'm just thinking it's a little bit too late. No portal keys on Gauntlet or Bubbles. Means that they're not going to be able to get off huge initiations from a far distance. And they're probably going to lose two towers right now. It should lose the mid and the top tower.
Yeah, at least they keep the racks, though. I mean, I think if Dark Lady failed, that would have been almost GG. I'm not even to be serious with you. Because, I mean, without Dark Lady closing in a Shrunken Head, I mean, Swiftblade's picking up so much farm. So is Hag and so is Bloodhunter. Those four deaths that were there was absolutely disastrous. I think they were definitely in the game, to put simply. But after those sort of disaster, it's looking very, very grim. I mean, it's not completely over. Dark Lady still hasn't died really yet. And before a Shrunken Head, maybe they're going to wait for one more team fight in terms of when Dark Lady gets a Shrunken Head, and then see what happens from there. But
I think they really need the portal key on Gauntlet. Like, that is the thing they need more than anything else right now. Because as long as they have all their players alive and a portal key on Gauntlet, there's no way for this Hellborn team to break base. Like, it's just going to be too dangerous to sit there in front of tier 3 towers. But as you're getting closer to Shrunken Headsville, population to Hellborn, maybe that becomes a little bit less scary. And they do have Shrunken Heads now, by the way, as well as a Shroud on Swiftblade.
Yeah, and I mean, the initiation has just been Gauntlet hooking into his team, which has been fine. But I mean, what now? Hag's picked up his Shrunken Head. Bloodhunter's got his Shrunken Head. It's gonna be so much harder to really initiate and get good initiations off without the portal key. And actually, Gauntlet might be in trouble here. Hag with haste and DD actually a deadly combo, looking for someone. Rhapsody must
find Rhapsody. Yeah, she's sitting on Strider's not gonna be enough, and the autos coming in from Sidecrash are going to be enough, and we'll see if they're going to get more. It certainly looks that way. Gauntlet going to go with a hook, but here comes the Bloodhunter ultimate. Will they be able to get away from this? It's going to happen. Chain reaction dodged via the teleportation. See you later.
Dark Lady does have Shrunken Head, though, so this is the last stand. Can they defend? That is the question, dude.
They do not have Gauntlet ultimate. They are down a Rhapsody, but it looks like the Hellborn team is not quite ready to push just yet. They will have Rhapsody back up by then, but the other side does not have the Bloodhunter ultimate for another 40 seconds. And it looks like they're just going to step right up. Gauntlet misses the hook, and this is why he needs a portal key. Push forward on the torture. Bubbles not going to drop the ultimate, and here it comes. Going to connect onto two. One of them Shrunken Head. Swiftblade gets a Shroud delivered. Wretched Hag going to be silenced up even through the Shrunken Head. Oh, Rhapsody ultimate going to save Dark Lady. TDL going to get away for now. Bloodhunter still chasing. Dark Lady turns around, is going to go for the kill. Bloodhunter going to fall. And Glacius in the background gets off a big ultimate, finishes off Rhapsody. Bubbles bites back. And it looks like the Legion team is going to continue the chase. Will they be able to find the people they're looking for? Bubbles, shell surfs forward, has a push tick in 5 seconds. They're probably going to be able to get either the Torture or plus one, but Bloodhunter bought back. He's coming in. Gauntlet going for a kill on the Wretched Hag. Not going to happen, buddy. Going to try to TP away. Part Deuce. Not going to happen. Oh, Dark Lady comes in. Finishes off one. Will he be able to get the Torture? The Impalement going off, and now it's Dark Lady. Going to be the one that's in trouble. Gauntlet is dead. And Dark Lady joins him in a grave right there in the Legion jungle. Parasite looking for an Invis rune and, well, finds it. But is it really going to do anything? Well, Glacius. I guess he's going to get a kill on the Glacius. Yay! Is he...
Parasite?
Bitch slapped!
Okay.
He's back over here.
Wait, what?
I just could... That is a really good juke spot though, coming from the Glacius. I don't think Parasite even noticed even there.
Wait,
so
really?
No, he's going to get away, actually. That was pretty insane juke.
Okay. Well, he's at least going to try to set up on the Bloodhunter, maybe thinking that it's more important that he gets back over here and goes for the auto attack and then is immediately killed.
Lag, beef. He was lag.
Questionable. Yep. And silence is available here for Bubbles, so Bubbles will now die. Although Gauntlet's here! But Bloodhunter's going to be able to get the ultimate out on Bubbles. The hook is going to be missed. And so Slask D. Rhett is gone from the God hook or Super KGE to some less than ideal hooks in the past few minutes. In either case, I think it's time for the guys on Donkey Kong to start thinking seriously about Game 2.
I don't know. I mean, it's looking very, very bad, I know, but they only lost the range rats. Okay. I mean, when they did start the initial team fight as well, Rhapsody was down, and so is Gauntlet Tournament. But if they can maybe have like a good initiation, I mean, I'm not saying they can win a team fight, but I mean, miracles do happen, Beef. This is the world of New Earth. Miracles can happen, and they do come true.
There you go.
Another stat coming out from Quincy. Beef, you want to talk about that one?
Yeah, man. Hellborn Tricorps, each one of them loses winning percent past 30 minutes. The Tricorp being Swiftblade, Wretched Hag, and Bloodhunter. So, probably one to finish right there. And as you said, all they lost was the ranged Rex. The Melee Rex stand. Dark Lady was able to get a couple kills right there. But speaking of TDL, she's going to have to retreat there in the bottom lane. 1,600 gold to her name. And what do you think she looks for next? Does she need a Firebrand for that mobility?
I think Firebrand could work as well as the Geomancer, but I think they can you can disjoint the Glacius Imprisonment as well as the some of the Haunt as well. So like this is the sort of mobility he probably needs. I mean, he's got the Shrunken Head now, which is like one thing, but I think adding that extra bit of damage as well as the mobility is just something perfect for him, really. But Hellborn does take another Kongwa, so unless they can really take down the Swiftblade before the team fight, it's going to look very, very rough here for the Legion side. I mean, backs are against the wall, but I mean, with a great initiation, Porky is now on Gauntlet. So initiations could definitely happen right now.
I would agree. They, with that portal key, might be able to get what they need. And I mean, it does definitely make it a little bit easier to hook people back into your base and set up the initiations in the way that you're looking for them. Bring them back in where Rhapsody's going to be able to stun, where Rhapsody's going to be able to get off the ult for a counter initiation. Hey, Bubbles still does not have a portal key himself. He has instead picked up another Neophyte's book, so maybe a puzzle box or something, but Bubbles going to drop the Shell Surf for a little bit of damage. And the Hellborn team, they're all in on this tower, saying, if you're not able to get back to us, then that's an issue for you. And Parasite is coming back finally. Here's Gauntlet with the ultimate onto three. Dark Lady gonna be going in. Shrunken Head activated up. Gonna be able to finish off Swiftblade, but a token of life brings him back to life. Rhapsody is already dead, and Dark Lady is running. Glacius ultimate in the background. Gonna be able to finish off Bubbles and Hag going all the way to the well. Swiftblade has the ultimate available. The Gauntlet hook is going to miss. Parasite falls up on the racks. And I think this could very well be GG's coming up from our Legion squad. Icebrand was the choice from Dark Lady. Don't like that pickup, but I don't think it's particularly relevant at this point. And now it looks...
Finished it off. Swiftblade.
Not the one you want, because there's the Swift Slashes. Might take a little while chewing through that Shrunken Head, but he's going to be able to get out of there one way or the other. 42-20, going to be our final stat line here. Because GG's are being called, Legion team throws up to concede. Dark Lady wants one more kill, but I don't know if it's going to happen. Okay, he'll finish it off. Make it two, just for good measure. ALG going to fall as File picks a couple up, too little too late. 1-0, going to be the favor here for the guys on Adrian's family. And Donkey Kong looked good yesterday. They looked good at points in this game, but Adrian's family could be a new favorite.
I mean, definitely. They played absolutely amazing.